everyone, this is Lynn and Patrick. Today we are right next to La Jolla Cove. We are going to talk about how much will unemployment affect real estate.
As no, it's all a big talk right now. In the last 5 weeks, 26.5 million people have lost their jobs, which means unemployment has risen to 8.4%.
Yes, there is no doubt the country hasn't seen job losses this quickly in almost 100 years.
Well, it could get worse. Goldman Sachs projects unemployment rate will be 15% by the third quarter, but by the end of the fourth quarter, we're going to be back to single digits.
How will this affect home sales?
Well, first of all, let's look at how the unemployment rate affected home sales in the past from this graphic.
The last 30 years doesn't show a direct relationship between unemployment and home sales. The blue and the gray bars represent home sales, while the yellow lines is the unemployment rate. Take a look at numbers 1 through 4. Number one and number two, the unemployment rate was rising between 1992 to 1993 and 2001 to 2003, and home sales increased. Number three, the unemployment rate was rising between 2007 to 2010, and the home sales significantly decreased because of housing crisis. Number four, the unemployment rate was falling continuously between 2015 to 2019, and home sales remain relatively flat.
So it seems the past impact of the unemployment rate doesn't seem to have an impact as strong as we may think.
It's logical to think there would be a direct correlation between the unemployment rate and the home sales.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
People who lost their jobs are not likely to buy a home anytime soon.
Yeah, that's true. Even the millions who haven't been laid off or lost their jobs yet, they're likely to hold off about a major purchase, you know, fearing that sense of loss coming up.
Even wealthy buyers are not likely to be comfortable to purchase properties in the current situation.
Yeah, that's right. And at this point, what's happening is sellers are opting to take their market and properties off the market until after the situation improves. So we're seeing sales volume and sales slowing down as there are simply fewer buyers out there in the market. And the price, well, price will also continue to be a bit slow on the price increases.
Here are some other factors we want to point out. There's a severe housing shortage in San Diego. Builders haven't been putting up enough homes to meet demand for years.
That's true. And there's also, just want to point out, there isn't likely to be a huge flow of foreclosures because borrowers are in a much better financial shape than they have been in the past. The equity in their homes, what we call equity rich, California is one of the highest in the nation, where people have more equity than they have on their loan at 50% or greater. San Diego is one of the highest at 40%. So with that money that they have invested in their home, it's not all a big loan, it's much less likely that we'll see a lot of foreclosures.
And on top of all these reasons, the federal and many state governments, along with some banks, are rolling out programs to help Americans who have lost their jobs.
Yes, that's true. And that's likely to help stabilize prices as well. So to conclude, the current unemployment rates caused by the coronavirus will for sure influence the volume, but may not influence the price of the properties or the value of the properties.
See our next video to see if we think an economic recession will imply housing recession. Thank you for following us and see you next time. Bye.
Bye now.